was some crazy stuff there. Baker in Montana. Hi, Baker. Welcome to the program, bud.
Gee, good to talk to you again. I hope you and the dads have been great. A couple of things. In back to Odell, you know, I think that all NFL receivers, rookies, should be put through an introduction to the NFL with Larry Fitzgerald as someone to emulate, because that guy just does it right. But the real reason I was calling is I have a theory as it relates to the ratings. And, you know, Chris, that previous caller, touched on it a little bit. I can only speak from my own experience, but I'm in a fantasy football league. It happened, I'm going to age myself, but 21 consecutive years, the Rare Earth League football league. And so what I find myself doing on Sundays is just parking myself at the Red Zone channel. And so what I'm wondering is if the NFL's network in the Red Zone channel has in any way cannibalized the ratings.
Well, you've had big-time ratings, and the Red Zone's been around a long time. Did anybody say anything about the Red Zone last year? The ratings were great. The rating, at some point, the ratings have to level off. They just do. And I don't know if this is a correction, you know, market correction, but I think it's just a combination of a few things here. Maybe we're lacking great storylines. You have the debates. Maybe the matchups just aren't very good. You've had lopsided matchups as well. You put all that together through the first 4 weeks, and you're probably going to get some standard ratings. Yeah, McClellan.
Well, Rich Eisen hit on something interesting. I've seen some analysts say total viewership is up because like 2 million people watch the game on Twitter. So they're not. Are they measuring in mobile? You know, the NFL did this Twitter deal. Isn't that going to cut into their TV ratings a little bit?
But don't they how do they factor that in?
Well, they're just looking at, I've seen a lot of ratings. CBS is down this, NBC's down this.
But the total number of football fans might actually be up.
That's what some analysts are saying.
Yeah.
By just a little bit, that it's up because of social, media.
And that makes sense because nobody's stopping watching football. Name one person you know, experience with, who's, I'm really bored of this football stuff.
But
it's
you just
bad.
Had this survey that said 32% of 1,000 people are not watching because of these pregame protests.
Maybe they already weren't watching.
That's what I'd like to know. Like, it feels like it's flawed a little bit there. Skewed. All right, we'll come back. More of your phone calls right after this. 877-3DG Show.